Welcome home, Raiders. Tonight, it's a little bit of a light fare. It's a little bit of a light fare, but that is actually probably an okay thing because it's my last show for a bit for BattleNet Sports. So more on that right after the theme song as Convert to Raid presents BattleNet Sports. Welcome to BattleNet Sports, everybody. My name is Pat Crane. I am your host. And now that the theme music is done, now that it's finally over, I can tell you actually what's going on here in the studios of Convert to Raid. Here's the deal. I am going to be moving across country starting in a couple of weeks. So this is the perfect time. Not really. It's not really the perfect time, but it is the time that I am going to say goodbye for a little bit. And we will pick up the show again once I get to my new location somewhere in the Northern California region. And then we will pick up the show. And we will probably pick up the show as we are getting hyped up for BlizzCon. So I'm going to say that October, early October, late September possibly, but early October for sure. We will get the next BattleNet Sports in. We will catch you up on everything that happened in places like, oh, Montreal, which is actually holding so many key things for so many people. and we'll be determining kind of where some of these players, some of these great champions will be, or if they will be going to BlizzCon. So that's all stuff to kind of watch out for. Also, we will be so today we will actually be checking in with Jewel Scott on HGC Haps and kind of what has been going on there, which is there's a lot of stuff going on. What can you say? We're getting closer to BlizzCon. We're 50 some odd days from BlizzCon, and now the real pressure is starting to be put on these players and these teams. So with that, we're going to whisk it away to Jewel Scott, and then I'll be back after that to talk more about other stuff, I'm sure. Here we go. Let's talk some HGC, and of course, to talk HGC, we need Jewel Scott because she knows all the things, and she is all-knowing, all-powerful. So, hi, Jules.
Hi.
And of course, you know Jules from like Torrent Think Tank and Heroes News with Jewel Scott.
That's right.
And that show is going like gangbusters.
It's awesome. I can't say enough. It's just been an awesome journey in getting into Heroes News reporting on an extended basis. So
cool. I'm happy. Awesome. Awesome. Well, make sure to check it out, guys. If you're into HGC at all, make sure to check out the show and give Jules some love over there on that channel. So let's talk some HGC. What are we seeing now that we are kind of nearing the end of phase two?
I think we're like smack right in the middle of the end. Like it's just we're halfway through. And it was week 7 last week. We had, I guess we had a little bit of a couple of upsets that came through, but on the whole, things are staying where we think they're going to stay for the rest of the season. We have 3 more weeks of regular season play before playoffs come in. So we can start with Europe and talk about that. So
sure. The
bottom two teams actually had some performances that were surprisingly good.
Wow.
Yeah, it was kind of cool. So number 8, Roll20 Esports, they actually got their first win against number 3, Method, which
cool.
is kind of crazy.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy.
Yeah.
And they just, like, they looked amazing the entire time. They were just like, they were in the zone. You could tell that they were practiced and prepared for this team, and Method didn't know what to do with them. So,
well, and of course, Roll20 just grabbed these guys, right? So
yeah.
Have they changed anything as far as, like, I probably not the team, but anything behind the scenes as far as you can tell?
Nothing that we've heard. Okay. You know, usually when a sponsor comes in, there's going to be some resources that the team didn't have access to before. Sure. And so they might have been given some more resources in terms of coaching, maybe performance coaching, counseling, even. Like, some teams have been hiring psychologists to a part of their teams. Cool. I know Hearth has a psychologist on their roster. So they haven't talked about it publicly, but that's, once a sponsor comes in, there's an organization that happens around the team itself that is just not happening when you're running yourself.
Sure.
So
sure.
It showed. Like, they came out and they performed. They got their first win in phase two, which doesn't sound like much, but against Method, who was just in Western Clash and they looked really good. It was a great thing to see, but Roll20 still sits in the number 8 spot, and they're most likely going to the Crucible to fight for their HGC life. So that was the big news for the week. And then there was also for EU, Monkey Menagerie, who was number 7, also like put up a great showing against Method, but they didn't win. They went through 2. I don't think there's much that could change, but there's still 3 more weeks of play for us to remain. So the bottom 2 teams are probably going to be there unless we are just going to see something insane in the next like 3 weeks.
Right.
So Dignitas still undefeated, still number 1, Liquid number 2, Method number 3, Fnatic 4th.
Right.
So there's your EU. What happened to the EU?
Yeah.
North America. So North America had a big like game upset that happened was Team Freedom, who went up against Temple Storm and they beat them 3-1. We were like, okay, that's kind of surprising.
Well, but, and you kind of called it too. Last week you said that this was going to be one of the games to watch. So make sure to check it out. And
it was a big upset.
That's great.
It was quite exciting. So then big upset. And then Freedom goes up against number 5 Endemic and loses 3-0. So you just never know what you're gonna get with Team Freedom. You just don't.
Right.
NA standings are pretty much unchanged. Heroes Hearth is in 1st place, and then Octolysis is in 4th place. LFM and No Tomorrow are sitting solidly in 7th and 8th, and they're most likely gonna be going to the Crucible. What Simplicity is also within shooting range of either not or going in. So so that's what happened in the games that happened on Saturday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah.
But just today, like noon o'clock today.
I always love that when the news just breaks right before you have to talk about it. It's great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm doing my thing.
Yep.
Checking my Twitter feed.
Mm-hmm.
And there is an announcement from Arthalon from Heroes Hearth Esports, the number 1 team in North America, right, that he is retiring effective immediately.
Whoa.
Yeah. That's
immediately
huge. And yeah, like now. No one saw this coming. Twitter was insanely lit up in disbelief. And Arthalon had posted a blog on Heroes Hearth and said that he was wanting to leave now because his heart wasn't in it any longer. He wants to pursue other options like streaming, possibly playing competitive Dota 2.
Uh-huh.
And he wanted to leave now so that Heroes Hearth had a chance to find a replacement before BlizzCon. It's a little difficult. Like, so the situation is that they cannot find a replacement player within a current HGC roster. And right now, the playoffs are going on. Look, the top team in the open division just locked their spot, which means their roster is locked and cannot be broken open.
Mm-hmm.
So like that's like the best of the open division, and they can't be touched.
Right.
There's another team vying for a second spot in the open division Crucible, like so the second place that goes up against the two teams in HGC. Those guys aren't going to be available. And so Heroes Hearth is in a tough position, and it was a blow to fans. It's difficult to kind of like wrap your head around it because this was our best possible, I guess, idea, hope that we would have a strong team going to BlizzCon.
Sure.
in North America. And so, I'm bummed. But you know, at the other side of it, and I will say this for sure, is that I know that it wouldn't have been an easy decision to make, because that team has been very, very, understanding and like a family. And so if things were not good for Arthelon, it took a lot for him to admit that he was not going to be able to make it through, like suck it up to two more months, right, for BlizzCon. You know what I mean, which is what a lot of Reddit is saying, is like, why couldn't he have just sucked it up and made it through BlizzCon? It's like, it's not, it ain't happening.
Well, and you know, I mean, the announcement, anytime that any player, I'll just throw it out there, politician, anytime that anybody says, I'm leaving immediately to spend time with my family. That's not exactly what he said, but he said kind of that. It's always, it's always like, whoa, what happened? What is going on? And people want to figure it out, because that seems like such a switch. But sometimes it does happen where you just lose your passion for whatever and you are done.
Yeah.
And apparently he's done. So.
Yeah, and you know, I got to give it to him to say that it was probably an excruciatingly hard decision to say I am done and I don't have the passion for this, because they're scrimming 6 hours a day, 6 days a week. They're playing, you know, competitive 1-2 weekends. Every weekend they're playing during the regular season. It's not an easy life.
No.
It was a pretty big shock, and it happened just today, so I know I'm still digesting it. Getting in there. So you're gonna see Heroes Hearth up again Friday, actually, against LFM Esports. They have a few weeks now to try out players before they have to lock in a roster before playoffs,
right?
So last weekend they played with a sub, because McIntyre, one of their offlaner, he was actually getting married. So they had a sub. And so that sub may be back in. That same person may be back in on Friday. We don't know.
All right.
Yeah.
So this weekend.
Yes.
What do we got coming up? What are we looking for, other than, of course, Heroes Hearth, whoever they bring in. Coming in and trying out. What games are looking good for the folks out there that want to watch them live?
So I'll start with North America. Team Octalysis versus Tempo Storm. That's going to be a bang up match, as always. And that's Friday at 6:00 Central. And then Heroes Hearth versus Octalysis also, Sunday at 6 p.m. Central. So those are bound to be fireworks matches and could have some pretty big implications for how the standings are going to shift.
Cool.
So that's good there. EU, Team Liquid. We've got Team Liquid versus Leftovers at Saturday at 11. Granite Gaming versus Roll20. Granite Gaming is still kind of sitting down in number 6. So this could have some implications for the Crucible. That's Saturday at 1 p.m. Central. And then Fnatic versus Method, the big names going up against each other Sunday at 1:00.
Cool.
So that's what I would say. Since we are not going to be doing the show for a little bit because of your break,
right?
The things that you'll want to watch in the next few weeks is to check out what the top standings are going to be and what the bottom standings are going to be. We have
right,
because playoffs are coming and the Crucible is coming, and there's going to be some shifting. You can see that's going to happen.
I mean, as far as what we can tell right now, though, when you take a look at the top two and the bottom two, they seem to be pretty solidly in the top and or the bottom. Well, not and or. It would just be or the bottom.
I would hope not.
Right. So they seem to be secured in their positions right now. I mean, you may see like one switch here and there, but. They seem to be all kind of going to where they're probably going to be going. Still some time, but...
Yeah, I think so. Dignitas, you know, Dignitas is going to be in the top. It's going to be between Liquid and Method of who's going to be second, third.
Right.
If Fnatic has a major run, they could move up in the standings for EU.
Right.
But North America, I just don't know. I don't know what to expect with the Heroes Hearth. They've got such a demanding lead right now.
Yeah.
But you're bringing in a brand new player, possibly more than one, right, as five people out. So it's open season now.
Yeah.
What's going to happen?
Well, so the cool thing is that it's all leading up to the end of this month when we start the actual playoffs. Playoffs start on the 28th of this month. And we will try to pick this up either just before the playoffs or at least right after the playoffs. We'll be there to kind of do a roundup of all those things and talk about more about BlizzCon and what we expect from that stuff, because man, I'm feeling the hype. That's all I'm saying. You know,
September rolled around and it was like BlizzCon hype went to 11.
Yeah. So, in October, it's going to be at about 15 because the playoffs actually start the week before BlizzCon. So they'll be starting the 25th ish somewhere around there. So that's going to be exciting and we're going to see all of that lead up. So we're only going to have like a couple of weeks off from all of these different esports before BlizzCon happens, and then we will be at the end of season one of Battle.net Sports, which is kind of weird. So
man, that's right, holy crap.
Yeah, so end of season one of this show, which would be amazing because then I could take a month off and recoup from all of the esports action that we've jam-packed into each episode.
You'll recoup. Like, I'll be crying in my coffee because I don't have it.
Something like that. Whatever. So there's that. Any last parting words about HGC before we get out of here?
I think it's just going to be a rocky road to the end. If you're an EU fan, I'm happy for you because I think Dignitas is your hope. It's going to be your beacon. Sure. I want to see EU do well if we can't in North America, but I'm going to hold out hope that we're going to keep on keeping on for North America. If you're a fan out there, keep plugging for those that are fighting their way through, because it's going to get exciting in the next couple weeks.
Right on. All right. Make sure to check out all of Jules's shows. They are Torin Think Tank. They are Nerf This. And then Heroes News with Jules Scott. Jules, thank you so much. And we will talk to you as soon as possible. Let's talk a little bit about StarCraft. Now, first of all, I'm not going to talk about WCS right now. No, I want to talk about the Asia Games, because as we talked about, we set it up a couple of months ago where the Asia Games were actually going to, you know, it's like an Olympics type of event, right? They actually have esports for the first time this year, and StarCraft was one of those games selected out of, you know, many. They had a handful. StarCraft was one of them. And Maru, who is the Korean champion, actually got a gold medal in StarCraft. What? Yes, it happened. And hopefully this will mean only good things for esports moving forward into kind of traditional sports areas. So esports and t-sports living together as one? What? It's like cats and dogs. Hopefully it can happen. I'm looking forward to see if this remains a trend and progresses more into not only just Asia, but also probably into Europe and then hopefully into North America and the rest of the world. So that would be really great. I'm looking forward to see what this means. But for now, we do have gold winners in esports from the Asia Games, which is great. And a big congratulations to Maru for that. So let's talk a little bit about WCS. And here is the deal. We have two lock-ins right now. We have Cyril, who has won all of the points, as I talked about last week, has about four times as many points as the rest of the players. So obvious choice, plus also won three, you know, WCS tournaments. So has won the chair three times over. And there's only four tournaments like that. So the fourth one being in Montreal next weekend. It's kind of an exciting time. That's all I'm trying to say. We have Special is another one that is locked in. So we have two locked in. We have Neeb as number four and Showtime. Oh, sorry. Neeb is number three. Showtime is number four. Right now, it's looking like they're probably not going to drop below eight. Has Nurcio, Hero Marine, and Elazer. Those are the top eight as it stands right now. obviously, some other people might be able to pop in there, especially with Montreal still out there, because I will kind of give you a rundown of the points that they will receive, WCS points. And it runs down like this. Montreal winner receives 3,000 circuit points, runner-up 1,400, third and fourth, 900, and fifth through eighth, 600, and then it goes down from there. So if we have one of the guys that's maybe in the bottom eight do really well, this could, or the you know, top 15 do really well, this could push them up and make them a part of the top eight, which would be super cool for those guys. And because the top eight go to BlizzCon, only the top eight. It will be Montreal's kind of a big deal, kind of a last chance for some players. We still have some GSL stuff happening as well. So it's tightening up. The hype is real. BlizzCon is coming. BlizzCon is coming. It makes it sound like Game of Thrones. BlizzCon is coming. And these guys are trying to make all of the points happen. So keep tuned to GSL and especially Montreal when that pops up. This should be a rousing finish to the road to BlizzCon. I'm looking forward to it. And that is going to do it for this episode of BattleNet Sports. I want to thank Jules, of course. But I also want to thank Jocelyn Moffat and Thist for their help as well. Throughout the season of BattleNet Sports, really enjoyed working with those guys and really have learned a lot about, not just about the games, which I always learn about a little bit, but about the esport in general, but about these players and about kind of their stories and really starting to get into all things esports. And it's been a lot of fun for me. I hope it has been for you, and I hope that you guys have taken away something from it, either entertainment or information or both, hopefully. And I want to make sure that you guys give the other hosts of this show all of your love online and watch their stuff, listen to it, devour their content, so to speak, and just have a good time with it. BlizzCon is real, and like I said before, we will be doing another show before BlizzCon sometime. Probably early October is when we're going to pick it up, because all of the things will have happened. We will know more about who's going from HGC. We will know all of the things from Montreal, and so, you know, WCS and Hearthstone and all these different things, and we'll have more arena stuff to talk about for sure. And we'll also be able to pick up on Overwatch World Cup, which will, you know, have their grand finale at BlizzCon. So all this stuff is coming up. Oh, it's so fun. All right, I'm going to get out of here, but thank you guys so much for joining me, as always, and we will see you next time. Until then, bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye.